The fact that different kinds of organisms are able to grow from one single cell is an amazing phenomenon, and yet not everything is understood about it. During development, molecules called morphogens control how the embryo takes shape. Decapentaplegic, or DPP, is one of those morphogens, and it is particularly important in the fruit fly development, especially during the formation of its wing. Fly wings develop from a structure called the wing imaginal disc, and DPP is produced in a specific area within this disc and spreads in the tissue, forming a gradient. Such gradients provide information to cells so that they actually know what their fates should be. Therefore, the question we can ask is how the morphogen gradient is evolving when tissue grows, and what link can be made between the tissue growth and DPP concentration. Several phenomena can be observed thanks to fluorescence. First, as the disc is growing, DPP gradient gets longer and has a bigger amplitude. Now, if we compare DPP concentration in the tissue to the concentration in the production area, and that we use the relative distance to the source as a scale, we see that the gradient is constant. That means that DPP gradient is scaling with tissue size. A link can be made through mathematical analysis between tissue growth and DPP concentration. And this link is that cell division is correlated with an increase of DPP concentration of 41%. Finding such links between a molecular gradient and a global tissue behavior is actually a very important thing that can help us to understand organism patterning during development. Thank you for your attention.